The name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. The value of identity. The act of cleansing the temple, not only physical church or the physical chapel that we have here, it can also symbolize the purification of ourselves as individuals, as persons. This, just as the places of worship are sanctified, we too must be considered temples of the Holy Spirit, for we have undergone our own cleansing when we were baptized. And during baptism, if you check the ritual, we were called temple of the Holy Spirit, each one of us. Therefore, cleansing the temple involves discovering the true identity and recognizing the value of the temple in the community. We identify with our temple because it represents our values, what we believe, our faith. I remember Pope Francis during the times of the pandemic, 2021. He went to Iraq, of all places. When it was locked down, but he went to Iraq, 2021, March 7. One thing he did in Iraq is to visit devastated Christian churches in Iraq. There was a very powerful mass that he celebrated. At the background are destroyed temples of the church. He prayed for war victims in the square, among the ruins of several churches disseminated by the militants. Pope Francis, surrounded by shells of destroyed churches, arrives to pray for the victims of war at Mosul, Iraq, once de facto the capital of the ISIS. The temple is not a marketplace. We should avoid the essential confusion about the two. This clarification extends beyond the physical structures and buildings. It also involves the clear identity and understanding or the definition of our very personal identity. Wala naman pong masama sa palengke. There's nothing wrong with the marketplace. We need marketplaces for practical reasons. But it should not be confused with the identity of the church. Dapat po hindi pinagsasama to. Parehong malaga, pero our church has its distinct identity. Tayo po mga Pilipino, sanay tayo sa mga sari-sari store. Pumunta ka doon, nandun lahat. Doon sa Sapang Bato, dahil walang masyadong pharmacy, bumibili na rin kami ng gamot, at least yung mga over-the-counter gamot, sa sari-sari store, doon sa harapan namin. And you have also school supplies and also the other things that I'm surprised mayroon sila. Tunay na sari-sari store. Even nowadays, we have convenience store. Pero it's also good to have specialization. If you are a bakery, bring the best bread to the community. If you are a pharmacy, bring the best medicine for the community. If you are a hardware, bring the best supply for the construction needs of the community and maintenance. However, more than the sari-sari store, I also notice when we eat, our plates are also sari-sari. Did you attend wedding dinner, banquet, or maybe debut or birthday in a restaurant or catered food? Filipino usually eat with one plate, everything is there. First, you have the rice, of course. And then you have maybe kare-kare, okay? And then you have the bagoong. On the side, you have the fish fillet. The fish fillet also would have a sauce, which is a bit sweet. And then maybe on the side, you have a little vegetable. Huh? And then maybe a little beef. Special fish or beef na masarap. At siyempre, sa dulo, meron tayong dessert. Lalagyan natin ng kung may leche plan, leche plan. Kung may saging, may saging. the whole plate is sari-sari also. I heard once a French chef, a friend of Bishop Ambo. He was talking about the Filipino food. The French chef said, "Filipinos, you have good food, but you mix it together. You don't enjoy it one at a time. Subukan niyo kumain. Ano lang, puro lengua, lengua lang, lengua. You will enjoy it. Or kumain kayo muna, yung sa plato ninyo, lagay niyo muna, ano yung bangus kasi na walang tinik? Yung arilieno, mama. Just enjoy it. It's very good. Or maybe asado. They are also very good. But when you mix it together, it loses its identity. Even our tongue, our palate cannot define what we are eating. May kaibigan naman akong pare, si Father Saul Gabriel. Sabi niya, when I order pizza, I order only one flavor. Kung cheese lang. Kung may ham lang. So that I could enjoy the flavor. But when you put the all combination, it's more expensive, of course. Sometimes, though it feels good that you're eating the best because it's the combination, but you cannot identify what you are eating anymore. I think Jesus is very particular with this. When it is a temple, it's a temple. It should not be mixed with the marketplace. In fact, he was very passionate about it. Never I heard Jesus very angry. Pinagtutumba niya po yung mga lamesa. He drove away the oxen, the goats, the doves. Imagine dito sa loob ng simbahan natin, mayroong baka, may kambing, at saka may mga money changers. It must be very noisy. Even competing with the solemnity of prayers in the temple area itself. Meron akong kaibigan, meron siyang steakhouse. One time, he hosted a lunch just for us. He did that order from the restaurant because he owns the restaurant. And he knows, of course, the chef is his employee. Pinakain kami, tom yum. Alam niyo po yung tom yum? Parang Thai soup. No? Ang sarap-sarap. I really enjoyed it. More than Thai restaurants. Sabi ko sa kaibigan ko may steakhouse, ba't di mo sama ito sa menu? Ang sarap ng soup na to. Sigurado pag pupunta mga tao, natikman to. O order sila ng tom yum mo. Sabi. And then he smiled, "No, Father, I will not put that in my menu. I might lose the identity of our restaurant. It's a steakhouse. Pero gusto mo umorder ng tom yum, dito ka, sabihin mo lang sa waiter, he can cook it for you. But not in our menu. We don't want to lose our identity." My dear friends, this is also true for ourselves. There's this psychologist, his name is Erik Erikson. He was talking about identity crisis. Especially for the young, when they are into transition, they do not understand their role. Maybe their calling. Maybe they're questioning their own values, belief systems, and choices. Especially when they are exposed to a lot of isms and ideas and many different cultures. You begin to identify with different groups and you become confused with your identity. Sino ba ako? Ano ba talaga ako? You have to make a choice. During this process, when you discover your identity, this is the only way you can have peace and real purpose in life. Not only the buildings would have identity crisis like the temple and the marketplace, even for persons, we may also have what we call identity crisis in our roles. Because we do a lot of things, we wear a lot of hat. I am a CEO, I am a president in one organization, a treasurer in another group. But about at home, who are you? Did you watch a very old film and even a Broadway musical, yung Sound of Music? Last year, it was played in the Philippines. We watched it.
Didarte Santarita. And George Von Trapp, the father of 7 children. He was a commander in the army. And his 7 children are very wonderful children. But because he was in the military and he's already a widow, no wife to take care of the kids, he disciplined them the military way. He did not call them by name. He called them by the number 1, panganay yon, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The kids are coming over and they are like military men marching before their commander at home. It was a confusion of his identity. Good Maria came, a sister who used to be a nun, who came to be a nanny of the children. She did not only help the children to discover their identity, their gift, their person, their individuality. Even the father discovered that he's not a commander at home. He's the father of the children. And they needed the dad. It could be possible even in our home, we could have our own confusion. Baka nakalimutan mo, ikaw yung tatay. You have to take good care of them. Yes, you may discipline them, but up to the point that they should also feel your love and compassion. For them to have confidence in their person as a parent. Baliktaran ho naman natin, di ba kung minsan yung mga bata ngayon, mga anak natin ngayon, di ba kung minsan napakatapang din, lakas ng boses, sumisigaw. Kung minsan sila pa yung nagagalit sa mga magulang, tapos umiyak yung magulang, hindi yung anak, no? Naalala ko yung mga matatanda noon, pag they would emphasize their authority, sasabihin ng matatanda, sige, may palit na lagyo. Parang exchange na tayo, ikaw na yung tatay, ikaw na yung nanay. Magtatatata, di ba? Maginda-inda, Kapampangan terms po yan. Parang nagnananay na, you are not, you should not be confused of your identity. You are a son, you are a daughter. I am your father, I am your mother. When we are confused with our identity, we lose the value of our dignity as persons. I remember most recently, a few years ago, in fact, an 850 years old cathedral in France, yung Notre Dame of Paris, was burned. Nasunog po yung simbahan na historical sa Paris. And you know, I watched a documentary how people were crying. Those who were baptized or married, those who go to church, and those who grew up with that cathedral. Find the cathedral, not only an edifice, not only a building, it was identity, their dignity, their history as a nation. That very night, while it was still burning, their president, the president of France, Emmanuel Macron, addressed the nation at the midnight while Notre Dame was burning. Sabi po niya, Notre Dame of Paris is our history. Emphasized by Macron, the president, underscoring the structures of this distinctive role in its national imagination. He highlighted it as an epicenter of French life, encompassing the essence of countless books, paintings, cultural elements that hold significance for all French men and women, even those who have never seen it physically or visited the cathedral. Notre Dame is, in essence, a shared culture and historical identity and heritage that resonates deeply with the entire French nation. And then sabi niya sa kanyang conclusion, I tell you solemnly tonight, we will build and rebuild this cathedral. Hindi pa po natapos na susunog, nag-commit na ang presidente ng France to rebuild their cathedral. Because it holds their identity and pride as a nation. In fact, I read somewhere, Macron was born in a non-religious, yung family niya walang religion. But when he was 12 years old, he opted to be baptized as Catholic.
Hindi ko po alam ngayon because of politics it may change, but even our buildings, I hope we identify with it. Ang ating simbahan dito, this is yours, this is us, this is ours. One time, I was tasked to work for the funding of a building in San Fernando. We called it EFATA. It is a development center for training. This is the time of Pinatubo. And in Germany, they agreed to fund the building. We call it EDC, EFATA Development Center. And then as we were building it and designing it, I submitted the design to the German counterpart. We call it Miserior of Germany. If we have Caritas Manila, in Germany, the Catholics have Miserior Germany. They give funds for development, especially for developing poor countries. And the context of Pinatubo, they funded the building. Very Filipino po ako. In the training center, at the side of the center, one of the halls, we decided it will be canteen. Lagyan namin canteen yung training center. Lagyan namin ng a place para pwede tayong kumain. Very Pinoy. And then the German engineer crossed out the canteen from the plan. He did not approve the cafeteria in the building. He said, isn't it we need to eat? During trainings, we have to serve food. No, Father Deo. The training center is for training. You build another building for a canteen. We are not funding a canteen inside a training center. I understood even in their way of thinking, the identity. We don't mix up how we run. Something that we do. Pwede rin sa business ninyo, you are over-expanding with a lot of things that is not your specialization. Alam nyo po, last August, nagpunta ako ng Vietnam. Weekday naman, walang isang... In Vietnam, the first restaurant we went to is a small... Yung style Vietnam, parang malilit lang, parang karinderya lang. Di ba yung karinderya is typical sari-sari store, sari-sari food, di ba? Karinderya. But in Vietnam, in that first restaurant we ate, they only serve one soup. One Vietnamese soup with beef. Yun lang. That's all. May choices ka lang kung ano yung lalagay mong patis o condiments. Pero they only serve one soup. And the manager and the owner are very relaxed because they only have one product. And you know, we were lined up. Ang haba ng pila. Isa lang ang sineserve nila. They knew what they do best. They have an identity. And the tourists in that place, they line up. Iba-ibang nationality ba naka-line up? Isa lang yung soup. Sometimes, mga Pilipino mahilig sa karinderya, sari-sari store mentality. At times, we lose our identity. Even our chapels and our temples, as Jesus reminded us, let your temple be a place of honor, a place of worship, a place of value of who we are. Huwag po sana kayong magalit na. May side comment lang ako. Most recently, napansin ko yung mga kabataan. Parang attractive din sa kanila magpakasal sa garden. Marami na po lumapit sa akin, Father, pwede po kaming magpag-garden wedding? Kasi sa simbahan ako nagkakasal. Kasi we are Catholics, we celebrate sacraments, particularly baptism and our wedding, our ordination in the church. As much as possible, siguro sa mga anointing, of course, sa bahay, sa hospital. But weddings, di ba may kasabihan tayo Pilipino, papakasalan kita kahit anong simbahan, di ba? Mayroon na bang nagsabi sa'yo, papakasalan kita kahit anong garden? Hindi, wala pa naman. I hope, hindi naman sana magalit yung mga ibang sekta. I don't blame other sect groups or other religious small groups. Kaya nagpapakasal sila sa garden. They don't have churches. Nagre-rent lang sila ng space sa isang building, second floor, di ba?
And they don't have the dignity of celebrating it in a church like ours, in a cathedral, in a parish place, where it's a center of our faith and identity. Hindi, Father. Sa beach resort naman po ito, pwede beach resort. Hindi rin, sabi ko eh. Simbahan talaga. And I hope we catechized our children about this. The dignity and identity of a Catholic wedding is not in a garden, not even in a restaurant, but in the church. Maybe kung anniversary nila lang, wedding anniversary, that's just a mass, hindi na po wedding yun. And a Thanksgiving, but we celebrate it in the midst of our church because this is who we are. This is our identity and dignity. Kaya when persons have their own confusion with their identity, titanong, sino ako? Unless you define your identity, you'll be confused and you will not be focused. Meron pong isang writer, pangalan niya Mark Twain, an American writer. Sabi niya, there are only 2 days that are important in your life. First, the day that you were born, and second, the day when you knew why. Dalawa lang yung araw na mahalaga sa buhay mo. Una, nung sinilang ka, siyempre. At yung kalawa, nalaman mo bakit kay sinilang. When you discovered your purpose, your identity in life. Let this be our invitation. The value of our identity. May God bless us all. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.